Back in the day, it was roughing it. We were painting houses and taking whatever gigs we could get, including the movie extra roles we did with the Keen miniseries, which was, looking back now, so much fun. And the liveliness we had in those lean and mean days. It was really a band of misfits, a band of literal brothers, a mishmash of band members who, you know, Macon was it back then. It was the southern rock scene, the capital of Capricorn Records, and it was a very hip vibe for us back then, from the days when Burnham Wood was on the verge of doing some kind of deal, and Riff would come to Macon and hang out with us, to the aftermath of Burnham Wood when we got with the remnants of White Witch and played with, you know, the glam rock scene for a little while in the late 70s. Afterward came Molly Hatchet, and I guess, as they say, the rest is history. You know, Riff just recently told me that we actually went to the Red Lamp, he, Pib, and I, and watched Molly Hatchet. You know, we used to see him there quite a bit way back before they were signed, and he said that Hib went back and told Pat the next day he needed to check these guys out. So who knows, maybe we were there, right, when they were getting discovered. But of course, you know, Riff always wanted to be a rock star. And I think this whole experience with touring and playing big festival stages and you know, being a well-attended performer is anyone's dream in this business. And, you know, he had a good career with these guys, and then later on as Gator Country, and, you know, he was able to do his things like Animal Magnetism, which was such a great accomplishment. I just remember how involved Riff was in things. He, I think, got a kick out of even being just one of the regular guys, even after he had joined up with Hatchet in their heyday, so to speak. He would even like to tag along with the crew truck, get there early, and, you know, even help set up and stuff. He was just really hands-on. And I think later on, after, so to speak, the band days, he was able to sort of have a dream job where, you know, he had a warehouse full of equipment and he would drive it out and drop it at Universal and set up a piano for Ray Charles or whatnot. And it was a great time. And of course, he's remembered in my mind for being on some of the most popular tunes of all time. You know, at least having a paid gig playing some of the most popular tunes to be performed live, you know, their version of Skynyrd's Free Bird, a forever classic. And of course, later on with Foghat and Slow Ride, I mean, what a bass line to be playing as a paid gig every night. It's a great memory. He leaves a great legacy with his tunes. We're really blessed to be able to see his performances now, even on YouTube, and hear many great records that he helped create. And it's just so great a blessing to have seen some of this journey and to have shared some of it with a dude I call my brother from another mother, my big brother, Riff West. God bless.
and soul.